20 years or so, and has been handling the one of the major installation in Ahmedabad. We have from Excel Industries Mr. Munde, who will be taking you through the technological features of Excel composting machines and how to sell the compost, where to sell the compost. These are some of the burning issues of compost making. So may I invite Mr. Munde to deliver his talk. Mr. Saurabh Shah, who was to give the talk, he is not there. He has gone for outstation work. So we have his colleague, Mr. Munde. And Mr. Munde will be followed by Ms. Arya Tiwari from Redo Natura. Do we have with us Ms. Rotary and Lata Jha with us? Yes, thanks. And then we have Jayadeep Saptarsi from Bhami Gold. Yeah. And then Ajit Kude from Abney Enterprises. Yeah, thanks.
Good afternoon, everybody. It's a nice session for the waste management, either in the form of centralized waste management or the decentralized waste management. Finally, we have to focus on the waste management to convert into the compost or either any form of the, any useful form to recover the waste into the energy. All of us know about the Excel Industries. Our establishment is from 1941. So we are 75-year-old company, and in the field of waste management, we started our careers during the 1990s. So almost we are completed around 28 years in the field of waste management. We started our journey with the centralized waste managements. So all of us are very known about the waste generations. It is in the form of mixed waste. Peoples are not completely aware about the segregation of the waste into dry waste and the wet waste. So at 90s, total waste is coming in the form of mixed conditions. It's contained the recyclable waste, dry waste, as well as the wet waste, and all together we are converting into the composting, into the good good form of the compost that will be the very useful in the agriculture field. But after lifting the waste into the centralized location and doing the composting, problem is not completely solved. Because the waste is moving from the different location to the centralized locations, and it's generate the volume of the waste, and we have to focus to treat it in a scientific way. And because of the mixed nature of the waste, ultimately the treatment volume is increased with the total waste. If we can start to segregate it into the dry waste and the wet waste, ultimately the treatment part will be the very lesser as compared to the mixed part. So during 2000, the MSW guidelines has comes into the existence and started to segregate dry and wet waste. There is a simple definition: dry waste, it is a recyclable, and wet waste, it is a convertible into the compost or any type of the energetical form. It may be the compost, it may be the biogas. So from the 2000, we started to do some research and development in respect to the decentralized waste management. And from 2000 to the 2005, we developed the decentralized waste management solution at source level treatment. That's called as a OWC, organic waste converter. And at that time, we got a patent for that also. And till the date, we delivered more than 3,000 installations at Pan India level. To the all bulk waste generators, it may be the housing societies, hotels, clubs, resorts, temple, educational institutes. So everywhere we install that OWC, organic waste converter, and it's running efficiently till the date. So now I'm going to start my presentation actually. So this is the Excel journey last from the 35 years in the waste management. If you can see the that graphical presentations when we started the Excel journey in respect to the waste management. First upon the we are in the field of the centralized waste management, and we have delivered around 19 plants at pan India level for 100 tons per day to the 1000 tons per day. And all these plants were ran on the technology of Excel Industries with the aerobic composting process. And as on today, we are operating one plant at Ahmedabad with the capacity of 500 metric tons per day. Apart from that, one plant is 300 metric tons per day is operating at Mauritius. So both the plants are, we are operating with the mixed waste. And ultimately, all of you know, from the mixed waste, what will be the outcomes is the compost, and it gets around 15 to 20% of the compost because of the mixed nature. After that, we started the decentralized composting. And organic waste composter, OWC, is born during the year of 2006. And last from the 12 years, we supplied more than 3,000 installations. Apart from that, OWC, we have developed some technology for the projects. It means for 2 metric tons, 5 metric tons, 10 metric tons, up to the 20 metric tons. And we delivered the projects, first projects for Pune, 2 metric tons per day till the date. It's run properly in Pune city at own municipal corporation, Pune Municipal Corporation at own site. Apart from that, we delivered 6 projects to the Panji Municipal Council, Panji Municipal Corporations for 6 TPD, 6 numbers of the plants are there, and for Mahapsa, 2 tons capacity, 3 projects are there. Then we delivered one project for 5 projects for the Uttarakhand APMC. And Uttarakhand APMC is particularly for the green waste only, and that plant capacity is from the 5 metric tons to the 20 metric tons. So we enter into the projects, small projects, on the technology based on the OWC, and they are running well till the date. Now, during 2010, we started to do the activity on the 24 hours process of the composting, and we have developed the bioneer. But we are not claiming as a compost we will get within 24 hours, but it's nuisance-free materials we are getting within 24 hours. Those having the space issues, they can try for the 24 hours composting process. But those who are interested for the final output is a compost or the manure, my suggestion is to go for the OWC, organic waste composter, and it's an aerobic process, and we are getting the natural compost within just 10 days. Then recently we have started the Mobi Trash service. So 2015, we launched the Mobi Trash service at Pune. And now we are operating 4 vans at different locations of the Pune to serving about 36 customers. And this type of the service is ready to use because our vehicles is at the doorstep of the end users. We are collecting the segregated waste. We are treating in front of them, and we are shifting to the centralized curing systems. And we are charging the per flat or the per kg base. So this system, now we reach up to the Surat Municipal Corporations, then Indore Municipal Corporation, Rajkot Municipal Corporations, and recently we have started in the South Mumbai with the 2 vans, and we are giving the service to the South Mumbai region. And during the last month, this Mobi Trash service is inaugurated by the Thane Municipal Corporations Commissioner, and we started the same activity in Thane also. So this is a ready solutions at doorstep to treat the waste and cart away for the further process of the composting. Next. If you can see the mixed waste and segregated organic waste, how to treat it. So with the help of the centralized plant as well as the decentralized waste plant. And once we get the segregated organic waste, it is very easy to convert into the compost at a very short space also. Here, various type of the models we have for the OWC, that's ranging from the 100 kg up to the 3000 kgs. So OWC 30, 60, 130, 300, 500, these are the models for the OWC. And along with that, once we convert that waste into the raw compost with the homogenization process and the aerobic composting process, for the same process we are using the bioaquilum as a microbial culture to facilitate the process of the composting. And then we are keeping the material into the curing racks. Here we can see the single curing system and the double curing system. So single curing system, it means it can cater for the 100 kg per day capacity, and double curing system, it means to cater for the 200 kg capacity. So we can start with the 100 kg and we can give that solution up to the 5 tons per day capacity. Only the number of curing system will increase, depends on the total quantity of the waste, but almost we are solving the problem. If we are considering the 5 members in one family, so the smaller system can cater up to the 100 families per day to take the care of their waste. Apart from the big townships, having the 5,000 flats, townships and all, we can serving the solutions through the OWC technology. And then other products are segregation table to segregate it into the two forms, just a dry waste and the wet waste, and then conveyor belts to take the output, and some manure trolleys to collect the compost. So these are the various type of the equipments we are deals with the decentralized waste management. Here we can see the process. First upon, we have to do the segregations. Then we have to add the segregated organic waste into the OWC machines and fix up the time for the 10 to 15 minutes to convert that waste into the raw compost. Same time, we are adding the microbial culture and the additives to absorb the excess moisture of the waste. Then after 10 to 15 days, material is completely converted into the free flow and the homogenized structure. After that, we are discharging into the crates and keeping into the curing system for further process of the composting. This is a short process of the OWC composting. Next. Then another product, automatic waste converter called as a bioenier. It is a 24-hour process. Any type of the organic waste, segregated organic waste, we should put up into the machines. For according to the capacities mentioned at there, it may be the 100, 200 kg, 300 or 400 kg. And we have to monitor the temperature and the moisture. And after 24 hours, is completely converted into the just like a raw compost, about free flow nature, and the volume reduction is around 15 to 20%. And once we start to add the waste, and at the stage of 6 or 7 days, it's full of the capacity. And on the 7 days, the overcomes will start it as a output. So these type of the machines we have delivered in the Pan India level, around 500 machines. Yeah, next one. These are the Excel's clientele list where we reach with our products. Here some corporate companies are there, some government organizations are there, then housing societies and educational institutes are there, hospitals are there, those who are generating the waste in bulk quantity where we are supplied the equipment. If you can see the sector-wise supply of the data, this data is last before 2 years and it is not updated. But now we reach from the 1480 up to the 3000, because last 2 years back, the SBM is in existence and the smart city concept is going on. And because of the Swachh Bharat missions, so awareness is increased day by day. So ultimately, the decentralized waste management business is also scaled up. And because of the SBM, so many bulk waste generators are started to think on the waste treatment and decentralized waste management, and they have started also. So it's either maybe the in-vessel composting or the OWC type of the technology or the biogas. And as well as the vermicomposting also is there. And now last from 1 year, we are seeing some type of the tumblers. They are also using to convert into the compost at smaller level of the societies, those who are generating 5 to 10 kg or the 20 kg of the waste per day. And our reach is not only in the Mumbai or the Maharashtra, but we reach up to Jammu and Kashmir, to the Kanyakumari, east to the western part of the India. Everywhere we are reached at there with the decentralized waste management solutions. And apart from that, we supplied some equipments to the abroad also. It's Sri Lanka, then Nepal, Philippines, South Asia. So most of the cities and the countries where we delivered our product with the good performance. Next. These are some of the recommendations we got from the various institutions and the organizations. It's may be the private as well as government or the semi-government organizations for the recommendations for this type of the technology. This is about the Mobi Trash. What I talk about the Mobi Trash, no? So it's a new concept, and people are facing the problems and issues in respect to the waste treatment at our premises. So nobody wants to install the machines or the any type of the technologies in their premises because there is a nuisance. Because people are not thinking to segregate properly or treat it in a scientific way. So, and small hotels, they don't have a space to keep the machines and all. Thereby, we started to launch the Mobi Trash service, and we got a tremendous response from the market, and they have greatly accepted this type of the solutions, because this is a ready solutions. And those who are interested to use the compost, so we are giving buyback to them also, the compost where we are converting into the, completing the process of the composting and returning back to the customer again. Those who are required the compost for the, their utilization. And most of the three small hotels, housing societies, education institutes, they are accepted these solutions. And our next plan is to reach not only the South Mumbai, but for the western and the northern part of the Mumbai, we have to approach it. And we have to start that services within very short period. Just see the van. This type of the van, we install the OWC machines inside the vehicles, and we are using the vehicle engine with the help of PTO to run the machines for 15 minutes or the 20 minutes batch cycle. And within vehicles, we are converting that waste into the raw compost. After that, we are stagging all the raw compost in a crates in the vehicles only. And every day evening, we are unloading the waste and started the further process of the composting. And also we are doing some awareness campaign for the students, how to segregate it. First upon, what do you mean by the waste management, how to segregate it and how to treat it at decentralized waste management. So these type of the awareness campaigning we are doing in Mumbai as well as the other cities to reach to the schools, students and all. Thank you very much. If any questions in respect to the waste management or my presentations, can you ask? Yeah. When the Mumbai Municipal Corporation has organized one exhibitions at Worli. So at that time, that exhibition inaugurated by our Chief Minister Devendra Phadanvis sir, accompanied by Amir Khan, then Amitabh Bachchan and the Uddhav Thackeray and all. At that time, our Chief Minister has committed all of us, we are going to start the Mahacompost. This is a new brand, Mahacompost, and we will set up the different centers across the Mumbai to collect that waste, those who are generating from the decentralized waste management. We will collect that, process it, and send to the rural area for the farming. So this type of the thinking is going on. But presently, those who are generating the compost, they are selling to the some nursery owners and for the garden developers. But in future, the huge quantity of the compost will generate So our government is also thinking on the same line to how to club all the centers together, and that huge quantity of the compost to be delivered to the rural area for the farming. So it is a combination for rural and the urban population. So urban population, those who are generating the waste, we will convert it into the compost, and then again goes to the rural area for the agriculture part of the process.
Okay, so good evening again, and I thank Algeji for inviting me here as a speaker. And on Rotary side, whatever we do about the waste or the environment or in the field of water, so many things we keep doing. So firstly, I've heard 2-3 speakers, and I'm really very, very impressed that what they're doing in the field of waste management is really remarkable. And the girl Meera, I mean, she's hats off to her, as everybody appreciated her habits and whatever change she has brought about, you know, to manage the waste. I mean, to not to create the waste first of all. सबसे पहले तो मैं ये कहूँगी कि ये waste generate कहाँ से होता है? हम लोग ही waste generate करते हैं. तो किसकी जिम्मेदारी है कि इस waste को manage किया जाए? So here I am speaking as a Rotarian, that who is responsible? We are responsible to, then who is responsible to manage the waste? It's our duty. If I speak about my life, myself, because if I go back and see what lifestyle I had earlier before 70, so I feel that us time mein to waste generation itna tha hi nahi, ye problem bhi nahi tha. And I used to visit my nani's place, which is extremely in rural areas. Wahan pe sab kuch chule pe banta tha. Matlab wo ekdam backward gaon tha. But I would say it was not backward if we see from today's perspective. Kyunki wahan pe khana chule pe banta tha. Jo kheti mein jo waste hota tha, usse chula jalaya jata tha. Ghar mein wahan pe gaay bhaise hoti thi. उनके डंग्स हैं उन लोग दे यूज टू मेक दैट गोबर का कंडा एंड वो चूल्हे में जलाया जाता था विच इज आई मीन वेस्ट जनरेशन होता ही नहीं था जो खाना बचता था वो घर के गाय भैंसों को डेली फ्रेश खिला दिया जाता था मतलब कुछ वेस्ट था ही नहीं तो आज ये वेस्ट इतना प्रॉब्लम क्यों बन गया है सो वॉट आई फील वॉट आई हैव सीन द चेंज इवन इन माई हाउस वेस्ट का कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं था क्योंकि हमारे किचन में एक डब्बा रहता था जो पहले डालडा या अच्छे घी का डब्बा रहता था टिन का उसी को ठीक करके रख देते थे किचन वेस्ट उसी में डंप होता था और किचन वेस्ट मतलब उसको लेने के लिए लोग आते थे और लेके चले जाते थे जो लैंडफिल में जाता था पेपर वेस्ट हमारी हैबिट थी कि हम लोग सेपरेटली रखते थे और वो रद्दी वाला आके लेके जाता था और उस वक्त कंप्यूटर्स मोबाइल थे नहीं तो ई वेस्ट का तो सवाल ही नहीं उठता है सो ओवर अ पीरियड व्हाट चेंज आई हैव सीन आई कैन शेयर माय एक्सपीरियंस विद यू कि डे बाय डे जो वेस्ट का प्रॉब्लम बढ़ता गया है विद अवर लाइफस्टाइल सो दैट एंड सेकेंडली द मॉडर्नाइजेशन इवन आई एम अ पार्ट ऑफ इट आई कॉल माई सेल्फ अ मॉडर्न वूमन बिकॉज माई हैबिट्स आर चेंज सो मच And I didn't realize over a period that how this change has happened as a slow poison it has imbibed in me, you know. अभी आज के टाइम में मैं भी देखती हूँ वेस्ट बहुत बड़ा प्रॉब्लम है आज से मैं जब 70s में थी उस वक्त मुझे वेस्ट इतना बड़ा प्रॉब्लम नहीं लगता था क्योंकि आज हमारी लाइफस्टाइल इतनी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड हो गई है एंड सेकेंडली द वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट हैज़ बिकम अ वेरी वेरी बिग बिजनेस और बिजनेस के साथ बहुत सी चीज़ें मार्केटिंग से लेके आती ही हैं आई एम सॉरी टू से आई मीन आई एम नॉट प्लीज़ डोंट फील दैट कोई इसको ऑफेंसिव ना माने लेकिन जो बिजनेस में है वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट के उन लोगों ने चीज़ों को और ज़्यादा कॉम्प्लिकेट बना दिया है मैं आज के दिन भी अपने घर में अपना वेस्ट खुद मैनेज करती हूँ और क्या करती हूँ मेरे पास एक मिट्टी का गमला है उसमें मैं अपना वेस्ट आई हार्डली जनरेट एवरी Family hardly generate half a kg of biodegradable waste, that is called kitchen waste. I keep all the papers separate. One day my Raddiwala comes, I just give a phone call. He comes, he takes away all the plastic, all the papers. Yeah, only thing that biscuit wrappers and all that, I don't know how to dispose them off. So all other waste, even today I manage. It's not difficult. मैं वो मिट्टी के गमले में वेस्ट डाल देती हूँ, उसको प्रॉपर एरेशन देती हूँ, उसके ऊपर थोड़ी सी मिट्टी स्प्रिंकल कर देती हूँ, उसको हर दिन थोड़ा सा चर्न कर देती हूँ. देर इज़ नो ऑर्डर, देर इज़ नथिंग. और वो वेस्ट, वो अभी तक मतलब महीनों महीनों वो गमला भरता ही नहीं है, क्योंकि वो रिड्यूस हो जाता है अपने आप वेस्ट. सो इट्स नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम. आई मीन वाई वी नीड सो मच, आई मीन नीड टू स्पेंड लैक्स ऑफ रुपीज. That is my personal opinion, but still I am also in creating awareness of waste management. So now I'll go to, I am also attached with some other NGO. We are also creating lot of awareness how to manage the waste. Three major kinds of waste we are generating. That is, one is the e-waste, and about 50 million of tons are being generated each year. And only out of 50 million tons, only 15 to 20% of the waste is recycled. And rest of the waste goes to landfill and incinerators. And what are the characteristics of hazardous waste? Second is the hazardous waste. And the characteristics are ignitability, reactivity, corrosivity, and toxicity. So why I'm saying about all these waste, that not only the biodegradable waste, we are generating lot many kinds of waste, and there is no way we found to get rid of it 100%. एनीवे मैं ओडब्ल्यूसी की बात करने वाली थी, जिसका प्रेजेंटेशन आपने देखा होगा. यहाँ पे बहुत से लोग हैं जिन्होंने ओडब्ल्यूसी की बात की है. तो हमारा जो एनजीओ है ग्रीनोसोनिक फाउंडेशन, उसके थ्रू हम लोगों ने भी खारघर ग्राम पंचायत में 2013 में वी वर्कड ऑन 13 हाउसिंग सोसाइटी, वे वी इंस्टॉल्ड 13 डिफरेंट कैपेसिटी मशीन्स. So it converts all the waste into compost, and the waste is not coming out from those societies. It is well managed by their by those societies internally only. So that presentation I think is not coming. And this is the second kind of system we have designed for a gram panchayat only. वहाँ पे उनके पास food industries हैं कुछ उनके area में. तो ये हमने एक 10 टन का बायोगैस का प्लांट हम लोगों ने डिज़ाइन किया. इट्स अ पोर्टेबल मशीन एंड इट विल जनरेट द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी विच कैन सपोर्ट अराउंड 750 टू 800 स्ट्रीट लाइट. एंड अपार्ट द प्लांट विल रन ऑन इट्स ओन इलेक्ट्रिसिटी व्हाट इट विल जनरेट. सो दिस इज वी आर इन प्रोसेस ऑफ डूइंग इट. बट देयर वी आर गेटिंग अ सेग्रीगेटेड वेस्ट इन टन्स which is pure food waste only. So food industries are there. So that is one of the advantage. And apart they have food, vegetable market and non-veg market also. Kya bolte hain usko? To wo bhi hum logon ko pure waste mil raha hai. To isse jo energy ka generation hoga, uska amount bhi kaafi achha hoga. I mean, it depends on what kind of waste you are getting. So these are the pure kind of waste we are getting, segregated. So the performance will also be very high, very good. So these are the solutions we have. I mean, this is the installed plant. It is 250 kg and it's been installed in a MNC. It takes all the kitchen and canteen waste and it supplies the gas generated there to their kitchen only. तो ये किचन के बाहर ही है, वेस्ट आके यहाँ डाला जाता है और वहाँ से उस कुकिंग गैस वहाँ सप्लाई कर देते हैं. सो इट्स अ वेरी कंफर्टेबल थिंग फॉर देम. Secondly, this portable biogas system. And third, the tumbler system. I think the tumbler system is most economical and cost effective in today's time, because most of the societies, they don't have lakhs of rupees to invest in OWC or any these kind of systems. So they prefer the tumbler system. And the tumbler system, one what we are proposing, it has a very nice aeration system. So which is where it's been installed all over Bombay. And people are really very happy with the tumbler system. And the kind of compost they're getting is absolutely dry and good quality compost. So this presentation I'm not able to show you. It's not opening. So, and apart, we are engaged in all wastewater treatment also. We are into solar, and especially we are into rainwater harvesting. So we are promoting a lot of groundwater recharge, though it is not a relevant subject for today. Oh, it has come. Yeah. Okay. This all I have already spoken. So this is the OWC I was talking about. From one side, if you put the garbage, from other side, you can collect the compost. It's a rotating drum system, and it requires minimum electricity. The drum rotates only for a minute or two in 1 to 2 hours. Yeah, so you can see that one side, if you put the garbage, the other side, you get that they absolutely dry sort of a compost. So these are different capacity machines are there. We have in Khargar we have done 2.65 tons ka garbage management. Second is tumbler system. Tumbler. The other Greenosonic Foundation. No, no. No, it's a rainwater harvesting system. Anyway, so thank you very much for patience listening. I understand that you are listening the same and same thing over and over again since beginning, and tomorrow again you are going to listen to same thing. So anyway, thank you.
We have Mr. Jaydeep Saptarshi from Vermigold. He will talk about vermicomposting.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is a presentation on a continuous in-vessel vermicomposting. To give a brief background about our company, we are a professional company providing decentralized solutions for the last around 10 years. The company was specifically formed to address the need for an innovative and technologically sound provider of environmentally sound systems. Our system is the system has got multiple global awards as well as Indian awards, and it delivers real benefits to the end user and the environment. Some of the awards won by our system are the Energy Globe Award from India, that's considered like the Oscars of the environment industry. We are the only Indian company listed on the United Nations Environment Program that lists us as the provider of environmentally sound technologies, as a sustainable technology provider, not only at the time of the procurement of the system, but they have done life cycle assessments across the entire life cycle of the product. The system has won multiple design awards from Australia, such as the Australian Design Award. Just go ahead. We recently won this award from Dr. Harshvardhan, Minister of Environment and Forests, for being the most innovative technology provider in India. Our products, it's a vermicomposter, and we have now We are also offering monitoring systems based on Internet of Things technology. So these are the three components of our system. One is the organic digester, one is then there are composting worms, and then there is a shredder machine. The system operations are collection of segregated organic waste at site, loading the waste into the shredder, and loading this shredded pulp into the digester. And there is daily automatic collection of fully mature solid as well as liquid fertilizer. This is a flow chart of how the system works. You have organic waste that's shredded and loaded into the digester, and the end output is vermicompost, organic fertilizer, as well as vermi-wash liquid fertilizer. Just go ahead. It's a basic design concept. On the left, you can see a traditional two-dimensional pit which has limited surface processing area. On the other hand, the organic digester is a triangular design where you can process up to three times as much waste in one unit of space. And by gravity, the vermicompost is automatically expelled, as well as the liquid fertilizer is collected in a tank, which is inbuilt into the system. Quality craftsmanship, using stainless steel components. There is no internal welding. The whole system is a press fit system, very long service life. We've got systems which are there in the open to sky environment. And it's really designed for long service life. System is designed in Australia, made in India, and exported worldwide. Next slide. This is the new technological innovation that we have now done in some of the sites where we have embedded sensors and cloud computing, and where actually these systems can be controlled from your mobile or desktop from anywhere in the world. This is a snapshot of the system management. Why is it the platform of choice? India's only global award-winning waste management system, compact, minimal footprint required, maximum waste processing capacity on minimal footprint, no nuisance operation, lowest operating costs, minimal power consumption, no heating, 90% waste reduction. You get high quality vermicompost as well as liquid fertilizer generation. This is a marketable green approach towards on-site waste management, and this is an elegant urban solution for hygienic waste management. These are some of our customers. Just go to the next slide. Some of our installations. This is Unilever at Andheri. We also have installations at their factories in India as well as in Bangladesh. This is Infosys. This next slide. This is a five-star hotel, Caravela in Goa. This is a housing society in Bangalore. We also have multiple housing societies in Mumbai. So just next, yeah. So this is a small video by HUL on the system operations. And I'll just, you can just click it.